Good morning, Kenley. How are you? Now, I want you to notice a couple of things, okay? I'm standing out in my backyard, and I have an umbrella over my head because it is a very rainy day here in Jacksonville. But I want you to know something, Kenley. Not even a rainy day is going to keep me from helping you to become a better writer. So I want to talk to you, first of all, about your notebook entry that looked amazing. You had really, really good details in there, and I loved the length. I learned a lot about you, and it was really enjoyable to read. Now, this week, Kenley, I'm going to keep you in the notebook, okay? I want you to stay there. I really like how it just lets you be creative and write about whatever you want to write about. I love it. It's my favorite thing. Now, I am going to challenge you this week to try a new strategy that I call explode the moment. Explode the moment. Now, a moment is a really small piece of time, isn't it, Kenley? So we're going to take a small piece of time and explode it by adding lots of really, really good details to add some depth to our writing, okay? Now, I'm going to take a moment in time from yesterday when I went to my son's football game. And it was the moment when I first walked into the stadium. And I want to use my five senses to describe it. So as I walked into the stadium with my folding chair, the first thing is, what did I hear? I heard the roar of the crowd. Everybody was on their feet, jumping up and down, making lots of noise because the team was scoring a touchdown. So I could hear that. So in my writing, I would say, I could hear the roar of the crowd. Okay. Now, what did I see? Okay. I did see players out on the field, but I want to go further than that to get that depth that I'm looking for. I want to talk about what I saw. I saw the players, after they made their touchdown, they were huddled up on the field. Okay, the home team was in one little circle, huddling and talking to their coach. And the away team was in another little circle, and they were talking to their coach. So in my writing, I would say, I saw the players huddled on the field, talking to their coaches. Because that's what I saw in that moment. Now, what did I feel? Because that's a sense, isn't it, Kenley? I was holding my chair, okay, my lawn chair. And so I could talk about that. I could talk about how it felt. Because it has that feel, that rough feel of the canvas. So I could say, I felt the rough canvas as I opened my folding chair. Okay, that's another detail that I could talk about. Okay, how did that feel? It felt rough on my skin. Now, it was a very hot night. It's really hot here in Florida right now. It's still summertime. I'm waiting for that cold weather, Kenley, but it's just not coming. So I had a drink that I wanted to drink with me. So I could say something like this. I felt the ice cold soda trickling down my throat on that hot summer night. See how I described that? The taste of the soda, it was ice cold, and I could feel it all the way down my throat because I was so hot. Okay, then my smell. Now, smell's kind of a hard one to get in there, but I was at a football game, and they were cooking on that grill. They were making hamburgers and hot dogs, so I could smell it, and I was hungry because I had not eaten dinner. So this is what I could say. Get ready for this. Are you ready? I could say, the hamburgers and hot dogs were calling my name. Now, Kenley, hamburgers and hot dogs, they can't really talk. Isn't that so silly? But that's personification. Okay, we could do that too. So I was really, really hungry, and I wanted some hamburgers and hot dogs. And that smell, the smell of them cooking, made me want to scamper over there and buy some so I could come sit and enjoy the rest of the game. So we could describe it up by using all of our five senses and adding lots and lots of detail. Okay? I want you to try that this week. I really am enjoying working with you on these awesome writing strategies. I want you to think of something that you could write in the notebook this week, or you could take a small moment in time, Kenley, and explode the moment. Give me some awesome, awesome details, and I can't wait to read it. I'll be talking to you soon. Bye.